Have you ever considered creating a style guide for your social media content? I created one for my business, and I gotta tell you, it is a total game changer. Today, I'm gonna share with you what I did, how I did it, and how it makes your life a heck of a lot easier. Episode 186 starts right now. Hey there, welcome to The Laura Shipman Show. We hang out here weekly to talk about things like social media, entrepreneurship, marketing, tools, strategies, tips, and it all starts right now. Hey there, before we get started with this show, I just want to share my passion with you. I love teaching people just like you how to master social media for business, breaking it down into easy to consume and easy to execute steps so that you can see immediate results. So whether you want to start a social media consultancy or grow your brand's presence on social media, I can help. I can help you get started and master all the things that you need to know. So I want you to go over to my website. It is filled with resources, tools, tips, and courses. Visit laurashipman.com. That's L-O-R-A Shipman.com to get all the goods. Now you ready for the show? I know I am. Let's get started. Well, hey there, everybody. Welcome back to the show. I am so excited you're here with me today because we're talking style guides for social media. And a lot of people may think to themselves, yeah, that's normal for like marketing and for websites and other things like that. But how does that actually work with social media? Well, my friends, it's exactly the same way. What you want to do is you want to create, it's actually part of just batching all your stuff. So imagine if you were in Canva, canva.com, that's my go-to social media graphic design program that I use. And you had everything there for your brand. Everything from fonts to colors to graphics to even little elements that make you uniquely you. And you had it already set up for you and ready to go. That is a style guide. And by doing those same repetitive things over and over again, it makes your brand or your content more recognizable. So here's what goes into my style guide. The first thing I do is I create a font list. These are a list of fonts, maybe three fonts that I use, the same ones over and over again on my actual graphics. And so when I go into Canva, they're already there, sitting there waiting for me to use. I don't have to search for them each and every time. Then I have a list of colors that I use, as well as variations of my logo that I use. So every time that I create content, a graphic piece of content, all that stuff is there and I'm just activating it on the graphic and not searching for it. It is the biggest time saver ever. Now to make this process go even quicker, I am huge into templates. And so I create templates in Canva that I rotate through so that it doesn't look like the same thing going out over and over again. And these templates are already preloaded with my font list, my colors, my logo variations. And so what I do is I usually post 5 times a week. Now this may sound a little bit like overkill at the beginning, but stick with me. Let's work with a 4-week month. So let's say we have 4 weeks in a month and I'm posting 5 times a week. So 5 times a week times 4 weeks is 20 posts. So what I do is I come up with 20 different templates. Yes, it's a lot of work on the front end, but on the back end, when I'm just banging out content, it goes very quick. So all I'm doing is dragging and dropping images into the template. And on that template, there's like a little photo placeholder. And so on Canva, I'll just grab the image, drop it in, and maybe I'll do a little tweak here and there with positioning, but that's all I'm doing. I'm not doing a lot of work. So to me, it's worth it to create these 20 templates right up front and then just drag and drop. And then before you know it, I have the graphics done and all I have to do is write a caption and boom, we are done. That is how I'm able to manage not only my content, but all of my clients' contents because I do the same thing for each client. I have their style guide all set up in my Canva account. And so all I'm doing again is rotating through templates, dragging and dropping, and it makes things go really quickly. The next thing you can do with your style guide is also apply filters. I'm not a big filter person, but if you are a filter person, you can add filters on Canva and use the same filters over and over again. So again, it brands you a little bit more and it stands out, like it just feels like your brand. So go ahead and don't be afraid to add those filters into your templates. And then when you have all of this done, if you're doing great with your social media graphic content and you're getting it out there pretty quickly, fantastic. But what this also does for you is it sets you up for a VA in the future. And here's what I mean. You've got that style guide already set up for your VA. You have no problems now worrying whether or not they're going to follow what your brand look and feel is because you've already got it in place for them. And then they just continue on with creating the content that you need, and they're more efficient and using their time the best way possible. The other thing you can include in your style guide is actually your hashtags. If you think about it, your hashtags are an expression of who you are, who your brand is, who you're trying to communicate with, right? So why not have them in your style guide? And here's what I recommend doing. Let's say that you post 3 times a week for your business on social media. So if you're posting 3 times a week and it's a 4-week month, that means you're coming up with 12 posts. So what I would do is I would create a document template that has 12 different captions ready to go or ready to be filled in. So in each slot, you're going to put a group of hashtags that you use on a regular basis. So what I like to do is use hashtags that brand my business, hashtags that go after the target market that I'm looking for, and then I'll leave some space for some customized hashtags depending on what the post is all about. The point is you want to have the majority of those hashtags already built out for you so you're not recreating the wheel every time. Imagine how much time that would save you from recreating the hashtag wheel every single time. It's a game changer. And then all you're really doing when it comes time to posting is throwing in a couple of hashtags that are customized to the post, to the actual content that you've put out there. The last thing that I would include in my style guide are calls to actions or post closing. So for example, there's always some sort of verbiage you're going to say to your audience. It's either going to say something like, click the link in my bio, or send me a DM if, or whatever that is. Or maybe sometimes you just like to end each and every post with the address of your business location. Whatever it looks like for you, think about how you can include that in your style guide. For example, I tend to use the same call to action whenever I promote my podcast. And it usually says something about clicking the link in my bio or sending me a DM for the direct download link. Well, instead of writing that every time, I just include that in my style guide for the written portion of my content, and things just go a lot faster. So I always tell people, if you find yourself writing the same things over and over and over again, think of a way to template it or to make it part of a guide or a style guide or something like that. It's just going to make you so much more efficient. And if you have a VA, it will make their time more efficient as well if you give them that written style guide or that template that you want them to use so that they can spend their time on more important things. Okay, my friends, that does it for this episode. I hope that was helpful, and I hope it got you thinking about how you can use style guides and templates to make your social media a little bit more efficient and quicker to get through. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, but most of all, stay social. Hey there, I just want to say thank you for spending time with me here today. I know your time is super valuable, which is why I am dedicated to providing lots of usable, actionable information in the shortest amount of time possible. Before you go, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a future episode. And if you have ideas or topics you would like me to cover in an upcoming show, let me know about it in the comment section provided.